Hi folks, we're watching the making of the legendary biryani at the legendary establishment Rahmath Hotel. This is an episode of Gourmet on the Road that you want to watch till the very end. This kalamakaya is cooked to the perfect texture. It's firm yet yielding on the bite.
I think he's in biryani heaven now.
I am.
We love to celebrate our food. We love to connect with our food. We are passionate about the food. And the only way to go in is with your hands. When it comes to meaty fare, there's one establishment that rules the roost here in Kozhikode. We are on Arabin Ghosh Road and we've come to Hotel Rahmath, an establishment that's been around for the last 59 years. So I'm here with Mr. Mohammed Sohail. And it was your father who started Hotel Rahmath.
Yeah.
And which year was this?
1961.
And what are the dishes here that are most popular?
Biryani.
And when it comes to biryani, Rahmath Hotel doesn't just do one type of biryani. They do many biryanis, and very popular here are the meaty biryanis.
Chicken, mutton.
The beef, the chicken, the mutton, and I think that's what people come here for. Right? So can we take a look at the making of some of this biryani? Let's go. Let's go and watch the making of some of the biryanis here at Hotel Rahmath. Let's go. It seems like a small establishment when you first enter, but as you enter, you find that the space leads to a larger space at the back. So we've arrived at one of the kitchens of Rahmath. This is where the biryani starts to take shape. Din mein kitne biryanis bante hain yahan pe?
1000 biryanis.
So the meat is getting mixed into the masala, tomato, ginger, garlic. So yahan pe garlic, akha garlic jata hai. And some chili. The green chilies with all those seeds. Yahan ka biryani spicy hota hai?
Haan,
thoda spicy. Isme kitna meat hoga?
25 kg.
25 kilos of meat. The onion, the urli that just went in. As he's mixing it, I can already feel the pungency of the chilies in this biryani pot rise up. I can already feel it in my eyes. I can already feel my eyes beginning to sting from the chili heat of the green chilies that's gone into this biryani pot. Thoda hi spicy hota hai. That's what he says. और जो आप ये बिरयानी प्रिपेयर करते हो सिर्फ वुड फायर पे
वुड फायर कोकोनट शेल
वुड फायर कोकोनट शेल इसमें क्या बन रहा है
चिकन बिरयानी
चिकन बिरयानी ओ ये पहला स्टेज होता है बिरयानी का
पहला
अनियंस है टोमेटोस है
जिंजर
गार्लिक
चिली
काफी है इसमें ग्रीन चिली है रेड चिली नहीं जाता है
चिली पाउडर भी नहीं जाता है
तो ये कलर कैसे आता है बिरयानी का
वो टर्मरिक है ना
सो देयर सम टर्मरिक दैट गोज इनटू दैट दैट गिव्स इट दैट कलर फुल बॉईल होता है यहां पे फुल कुक होता है
80%
सो द मीट इज 80% कुक्ड विद दैट मसाला तो ये जो बिरयानी है ये कौन सा दलिसरी स्टाइल है कैसा स्टाइल का बिरयानी है ये
हमारा
आपका स्टाइल है So this is the Rahmath style of biryani. Ye biryani aap pehle 59 years se bana rahe ho.
1980
se bana rahe ho biryani.
Pehle zyada beef hai.
Haan.
Abhi chicken.
Okay. Lekin jo Kozhikode mein jo biryani ka rivaaj hai, wo zyada tar aapke beef biryani ke pehle zyada kya tha? Chicken tha, mutton tha?
Chicken, mutton, fish.
Fish. Aur kya hai isme?
Meat boiling.
Meat boiling ho raha hai. For the beef biryani. So when I see this biryani, I see a lot of oil floating on top as opposed to that. So why is that?
Oil coming from the meat.
Oil coming from the meat. So this is already boiled.
Already boiled.
Because the color here is a lot. It's more reddish there as opposed to this. This is more yellowish.
Become reddish.
Oh, this will also become reddish.
Over the boil.
Ah, so kitna time lagta hai wo boil hone ko? 1 hour. Aur wo jo beef ka hai?
One and a half hour.
Thoda zyada. So today people come to KOZHIKODE and visit Rahmath Hotel for their meat biryanis. And that's what we're also going to taste. But uske pehle, dum dekhenge biryani ka. Let's go to the other kitchen. In the many kitchens that are here at Rahmath Hotel, where they dish out the biryani by the thousands of portions every single day. Ye sara biryani hai yahan pe.
Yeah.
There are pots and pots of biryani here. When you look around and see all these pots of biryani, you know that they are serious about their biryani, and you know this is what people come to Hotel Rahmath for. Khaima chawal.
Haan, khaima.
So I can see the tomatoes, I can see some cardamom, I can see some cloves, I can see some cinnamon. So now this rice will meet that meat masala layer by layer. I like the way they gently place the rice on that meat masala. There's no fuss. So now he's leveling the rice. There's some purichodli, or the what we know also as a brista, that is going in. So basically the coriander, the raisins, and also that fried onion. And some more of the rice. And another layer of the coriander, fried onion, and the raisins. Of course, some ghee as well. Biryani has now entered its final stage of cooking on dum. So all the burning embers of the coconut shell, of the wood, have now been placed on top of that biryani and also around that biryani pot. And what's also interesting is that they pack the rice all the way to the brim and they almost compact it. So they want that biryani to cook not just with the heat but also the pressure that builds up within the pot, because that pot is filled to the brim with the meat at the bottom and the rice on the top. They want that biryani, they want that rice to absorb all the flavors. So all the flavors of the meat masala at the bottom will rise up through that biryani pot, impregnating each grain of the rice with its unique savory flavor.
Ab kitna time lagega?
1 hour.
1 hour. So this will be on dum for an hour. So you can see that this rice is filled to the brim. So they remove the top layer of the rice, which has been in contact with the lid and also the heat from the embers. And also in the process, they're revealing the white grains of khaima rice in this biryani. So they're actually separating the rice. So you've got the white rice that goes into one of the pots. And then he's going to go for the rice with that masala. And that goes into another pot. Well, eventually the white rice and the masala rice come together. Now you have the meat that's beginning to make its presence. Suhail here has offered me a taste of the biryani right here in the kitchen. It just emerged from the pot. It's hot. The rice is hot. Can't even touch it. But the joy of eating a biryani like this. My goodness, that's a flavorful biryani. Now I know why people come to Hotel Rahmath for this biryani. That biryani jolts your senses awake. This biryani seizes hold of your palate and makes you want to have a conversation with it. That's what this biryani at Hotel Rahmath is all about. Oh my goodness. MashaAllah, this biryani is so good. It has absorbed all the spices of that masala. This meat is tender. Oh my goodness. This is definitely a biryani that I want to savor at leisure on the table. We've watched the cooking of that biryani and we're certainly going to taste some more of that biryani along with some other biryanis too here at Rahmath. But before that, I want to taste some of their curries. And that's what we're going to call for first. One kalumakaya fry. So one mutton stew, rice pathri. And after that, biryani. Chicken, mutton,
beef.
Correct, beef. So all three biryanis. you know, as I look around, every table has a biryani. And the very popular biryani here is a meat biryani. Because we are in KOZHIKODE, they love their meat. So you've got plenty of the beef biryani that's happening here. You've got plenty of the mutton biryani as well. And of course the chicken and the other biryanis that they do. They also do a squid biryani, they do a mussel biryani, they do a prawn biryani. So needless to say, Rahmath is the home for biryanis if you're in KOZHIKODE. And I'm looking forward to savoring some more of that biryani. But before tasting the biryani, we're going to taste the rice patri and the mutton stew. Stew. They don't call it the stew here, they call it the stew. The mutton stew here. Chicken biryani. Oh, it's hot, 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 hot. And the mussels. Fry, the kalamakai. Minus the shells, and of course, this is fried in an onion. Almost like a semi-gravy of sorts. It's moist, it's wet. I can see some green chilies as well. I'm sure there's some tomatoes that have gone into this as well. Let's begin with the mutton. The mutton stew. It's quite gentle in its aromas. This patri is hot. So it's like pulka that's made with rice. Some of that stew right away. Some of that stew, the curry first. The meat is cooked in a coconut milk broth, and that meat has absorbed the flavors of the stew really well. As you taste the stew, you also bite into the yielding crunch of the onions. So the onions have obviously simmered in the stew for a while. And there's also some potato that's gone into the stew, I think to thicken the gravy a bit. So you have tiny pieces of meat, so if you have two or three people, it's quite easy to share this particular dish. I love the creaminess of this stew. There's also some green chili in this stew. It's not a spicy stew at all, but you definitely taste a bit of that green chili heat. This patri is nice and soft. It's the perfect medium to mop up this stew. I've got the gravy and I've got some of that meat. That meat is tender, soft. I think next we're going to taste some kalamakaya fry. So this is not a dry fry, but it's a wet sort of a fry with some onions, with perhaps some tomatoes. I taste the sweet flavor of the fennel. There's some fennel that's gone into this kalamakaya fry. This kalamakaya is cooked to the perfect texture. It's firm yet yielding on the bite. And the fried onions lend it that delicious sweetness. And then you have the sweet acidity of the tomatoes or the takali. Oh, this is cooked beautifully. This is a delicious kalamakaya fry or the mussels fry. Think of the patri as an edible rag of sorts to which you can mop up all forms and textures of deliciousness off your plate. So whether it's a gravy, whether it's something in a semi-gravy like this mussels fry, the patri sure does a good job of mopping all those flavors and conveying them safely to your mouth. I should stop, as they say, you got to stop when the going is good. But this mussels, this kalamakaya definitely deserves a third serving on my plate. I can also now taste the heat of the green chili. It's a mellow, lingering sort of a heat. I think there's some ginger that's also gone into it. And it definitely asserts itself in the warmth that you feel beneath your tongue. Happiness. That's the look of happiness right here. Time now to taste the biryani. And we're making a beginning with a chicken biryani. Oh, this biryani is hot and it's still steaming away, as you can see. For my Kannada viewers, busy, busy biryani. And alongside the biryani, you have the raita, of course. And then you have a salad of cucumber. And then the pickle. This is a lemon pickle. Spicy lemon pickle with some chili and also some dates. So in this part of the country, they love eating their biryani with the pickle as well. So let's get to that biryani. This is extremely hot. This is a biryani that's made in Rahmath Hotel style. It's not a typical Talasseri biryani that you'll get around here. As you can see, there's generous chunks of tomato in the biryani, and this is the tomato that goes into the rice before it's added to the biryani. So that's the reason why you still have the akha or the whole tomato almost. I'm going to taste that rice first. You know, at Rahmath, when they serve the biryani, so they mix the rice and the masala together. So you're basically tasting the rice with a little bit of the masala in every mouthful. And then suddenly you bite into a raisin, a kishmish, and that transforms the flavors on your palate. So you're suddenly now tasting something sweet. And when you bite into some of this burnt onion, the fried onion, you taste that sweet, unctuous savouriness of that burnt onion, of that fried onion. Time now to taste this chicken. This chicken is moist, cooked twice, first in the masala and then as a biryani, cooked slowly and gently on dum for about an hour. It's still so hot. It's difficult to even tear a piece of the biryani off this bone. Finally succeeded. I'm going to taste some of that chicken with the rice. The chicken is quite gentle in its flavors. So when I saw the chicken masala pot boiling away, with all those ingredients and the spices, the flavor of the chicken in itself is quite mellow, it's quite gentle. And the chicken is cooked perfectly. It's nice and moist, just the way chicken should be cooked. I'm going to taste some of that chicken now with that rice, with some of the fried onions and also that raisin. If you like your chicken biryani mellow in its flavors, you'll enjoy this chicken biryani. But if you like it a little spicy, you can always perk up the action with this pickle, the lemon date chili pickle. You know, for the uninitiated, it may seem a little strange enjoying your biryani with pickle, but once you taste it, you definitely make note of the way it zings up the flavors on your palate. And if you feel the heat of that pickle is a little too much, well, you can always go to that raita. But don't smother your rice with that raita. Take the raita, place it gently in a corner of your plate, and go for it sparingly, just to moisten your rice a wee bit. You don't want to douse your rice with the raita and obliterate the gentle mellow flavors of this chicken biryani. Time to make some space on the table for the other two biryanis that we're going to taste here. So I've got the mutton biryani and the equally popular beef biryani. I'm told both these biryanis are hugely popular amongst the local patrons here. Hey, how are you doing? I'm doing well.
Carlos, what's your name?
My name is Kripal.
Kripal, oh, nice
yeah,
to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
I see you're doing a whole video here. You got a setup going on.
That's right. We're shooting some of the biryanis here. What brings you here?
The same thing, the biryani. Yeah. I already came here actually, but I came back because it's that good and I had more food to share. So
I've got plenty of biryani on my table. Do you want to share?
Yeah, let's do it. Why not?
We've got a guest. So you're Carlos.
Carlos Volpe, yeah. I have my YouTube channel, Volpe, Where Are You?
Volpe, Where Are You?
Volpe, Where Are You? Yes. And yours?
My name is Kripal Amana and I've got a YouTube channel called Food Lovers TV.
Food Lovers TV?
That's right. So there you go. So we've got an impromptu collab happening between Volpe, Where Are You? And Food Lovers TV.
We'll do it.
Tasting the biryanis here at Rahmath Hotel in KOZHIKODE'S. Let's do it. So what brings you to India?
The food.
The food?
I came to Calicut just for the food.
How long have you been here?
Been here 3 days. I was supposed to stay only 1 or 2 days, but the food been so good, I had to stay more and try more out.
Fantastic. I think food brings people together. No matter which part of the world you come from, I think food brings people together. I think that's a beautiful thing about food.
Exactly.
So now let's taste some of these biryanis first.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, let's start with the mutton.
Let's start with the mutton.
Oh, oh man, look at that. That looks tasty.
Lovely. So Carlos, in other parts of the country, we have the biryani and we have a bit of the raita, perhaps a bit of the salad.
Yeah.
But here in KOZHIKODE, we eat the biryani with, of course, some raita, which is like a yogurt-based salad.
Right.
And then you also have some cucumbers, some onions, because onions are very expensive now. So they
It's like gold, right?
It's like gold right now. If you have onions, you're a rich man.
You're a rich man, all right.
And then you have a spicy pickle, and which is interesting. When they eat the biryani, they like to mix the flavors up.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, they like to mix it with all these things. You get a whole different, it's a whole different biryani after.
Absolutely. So, I always like to taste the biryani first just by the rice.
I agree.
Right?
Let's start like that first. It's just, it's so good. You know?
If you taste the flavor of the meat in the rice, then you know it's a good biryani.
Yeah, exactly. When you get that extra flavor in there, it's just...
Absolutely.
An explosion in your mouth.
Every grain of this rice has soaked up the flavors of that masala. That mutton masala that's first cooked for about an hour, and then the rice is introduced to the mutton masala and then it's cooked on dam, it's cooked on steam for about an hour. So all the flavors of that masala are now trapped in this rice.
I won't forget my first biryani ever. It was a special moment. When I first tried it, it was about probably like 8 months ago or nine months ago. I was like, oh my God, what did I just eat? It is so good. And since that day, doesn't matter where I go in the world, I hunt down always an Indian restaurant just to have a biryani. Yeah, I think I need one per month, at least.
You know, biryani is such a comforting dish. It's a dish that takes time. It's a labor of love. But it's a dish that has everything on the plate. You've got the carbohydrate, you've got the protein, you've got the savouriness that comes from the masalas. So it's a complete dish, and of course with the nourishment that you get from the raita or some of the vegetables.
You get some vitamins
in
there.
You get it all.
Everything in one.
That's right. Next I'm going to go for the meat.
All right.
This meat is cooked to that perfect tenderness. You know, this meat is cooked to that perfect doneness. It's got all the masala outside and it's nice and pink on the inside. It's juicy pink. That's the way you want your meat to be cooked.
It's so good, right?
That's amazing.
It's an amazing, like an orgasm in your mouth. The meat is so soft. It just dissolves in your mouth.
This biryani also has a gentle acidity, tartness that comes from the tomato. When they cook the rice with some tomato. So that tomato brings in its mild, sweet acidity to that biryani, which is what takes that flavor in a different direction.
Right.
Well, that's the beautiful thing about a biryani. You travel 100 kilometers, you'll find an entirely different style of biryani. I'm sure as you've traveled through India over the last 3 or 4 months,
you've
tasted, I'm sure, many biryanis. But each one of them
is different.
Is different.
100%.
That's right.
You know, this is just the best dish ever created.
Yeah,
like,
it is.
This cannot be beaten.
I think what's nice here is that they give you a generous chop.
Yeah.
So you got plenty of the meat, and it's the meat that's been cooking on the bone, right? So as the meat's cooked for a couple of hours, all the juices leach out from the meat and find their way into the biryani. Where those juices then impregnate.
Exactly.
Every grain of that rice. So you're tasting the juiciness of the meat, the masala, the spices in every grain of that rice.
Exactly. Yep, that's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
And here they do it to perfection.
Absolutely. So amongst the meaty biryanis here, a very popular biryani here is a beef biryani.
Right.
And in this part of the country, people love their meats.
Yeah, they do.
So if you look around, you'll find almost every table has a beef biryani.
Yeah.
Right? So whilst it may be taboo elsewhere, but out here in KOZHIKODE,
it's perfectly fine.
That's right. So they celebrate the beef biryani, and that's what we're gonna taste.
Let's go for it. Wow, look at that chunk.
I mean, I love the fact that you're eating with your hands.
And here in India, it's something that I learned, you know, eating with the hand, and I feel like it enhances everything. You have a better connection with the food. It's more personal. You get to know if it's hot or not before you put it in your lips. Like right now, this is hot. It'll burn my lips, so my hand can take it.
You know what also happens? When you touch the warmth of this food, that triggers a reaction. It sets your palate on overdrive in anticipation of what lies ahead.
Right.
You can already feel your mouth moisten. And I think that's what it does. It connects you, your hands connect you to the food even before you taste it. And I think that's such a beautiful thing.
Yep.
Isn't it?
It's a connection, a better connection with the food.
Absolutely.
Before you eat it.
We love to celebrate our food. We love to connect with our food. We are passionate about the food. And the only way to go in is with your hands.
AKA the Indian spoon.
The Indian spoon, that's right. And I love the way you're doing it. You're doing it just right.
Oh, thank you. I've been trying to perfect it since my evolution.
You're perfect now, let me tell you that.
Thank you. I think he's in biryani heaven now.
I am.
So good. The juices from over here have gone into this biryani, into each grain, and it's just changed. It tastes completely different from the mutton biryani.
That's right, and I think that's a character of the meat. And it's also the case with the chicken. But what's interesting here is that although the flavors are very different, when you eat a chicken biryani, a mutton biryani, or let's say a beef biryani, they typically start out almost the same. So when I was watching the biryanis being cooked here at Rahmath, when I looked at the spices that went in, when I looked at the tomato, the onion, the garlic, the ginger, and all of that,
right,
it's all equal. But when that biryani starts cooking, they call it the masala, the meat masala, whether it's the chicken masala, the beef masala, the mutton masala, that's when the character, the personality of that meat takes over.
Right.
So the mutton biryani says, this is what I'm going to do. This is how I'm going to lend my flavor. This is how I'm going to share my personality. The chicken is not so assertive.
Yes.
Right? So it's mellow. It's shy. Whereas the beef, it's robust. It's full on. When you're eating a good biryani, you can linger over the rice. And so for instance, when you're tasting the biryani just by itself, just the rice, you taste the fulsome flavor. You taste a bit of the flavor because the juices of meat transform into stock, and that's what you taste. So that's the underlying flavor layer. And then as you pair it around in your rice, let's say you find some onions, you find some raisin, you find some chili, and then you scoop that into your mouth. You can now taste the sweet pop of the raisin.
Yeah, every time you put the raisin, it's a nice little
touch
in there, a little different when you get that raisin in your mouth.
When you get a bit of chili, you taste just a tingling sensation of heat. That's the beautiful thing about the rice in the biryani.
Exactly.
You know, so always,
each bite, it might be different, you know?
That's right.
Depends what you get in it, or sometimes there's cashews in there.
Mm. It's almost like romancing someone.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So you basically spend time.
That's looking for the right spot.
That's right. Time now to go for the meat.
So tender.
It is. Not as tender as the mutton, but you know, for beef, I think this is quite tender. It also spends longer cooking.
Yeah. That's good, right?
That salty savouriness of the meat. You know, this meat has a certain saltiness to it, which is what you taste. As soon as you bite into it, and that meat releases its flavors.
Yeah.
Releases its juices, that's what you taste. Do you want, there's a chutney with it.
I like it, but I don't like these chutneys that much of it. I'm a fan of it with the biryani, but overall, I always avoid the raita, the pickles.
Exactly. Those are my thoughts too. I think when you're tasting this biryani, you want to taste it just by itself. No distractions.
Nothing. I enjoy it just like that.
Just focus on the biryani.
So I think we've tasted three biryanis here, very different. The chicken biryani was mellow, almost shy. You had to draw that chicken, you had to draw the flavors out of it. And then you had that mutton biryani, which came along confidently, displaying those bold flavors. And then that meat biryani.
And it takes over.
And it takes over entirely. So now after this, you cannot really go back to this, the mutton biryani or to the chicken biryani. The chicken biryani will not be able to taste now.
It's not up to par. The meat biryani takes over.
That's right.
Too strong. The flavors, the juices, the way they flow into the rice, it's too much.
Fantastic. Sometimes you don't need to say anything. It's all here.
Just the pure satisfaction of it is like, it can be seen in the face.
You know, when we set out to explore KOZHIKODE, we received tons of recommendations. And many recommendations said, if you're going to KOZHIKODE, you have to visit Hotel Rahmath. And they said, when you visit Hotel Rahmath, you have to try the biryanis and the meaty biryanis. And many of the recommendations came in for the mutton and that beef biryani. And therefore, when you get so many suggestions, you definitely want to explore. And that's what we spent this morning doing, exploring the biryanis here at Hotel Rahmath. Rahmath is a culinary tradition and a legacy that goes back 59 years. And when you savor this biryani, you know the reason why this eatery stands tall for six decades.
100%.
For six decades in a row. And when you look around and you see people enjoying their meal, people happily tucking away into their biryani, you know Hotel Rahmath has a good thing going. And the other beautiful thing that happened here is that we met Carlos. Carlos was here looking to savor some biryani on a different table, but then we said, hey, why not? Let's come together and savor this food together. I think that's a beautiful thing about food too. Food brings people together. So Carlos, an honor to have you sharing the table with me.
Thank you so much.
Fantastic to meet you. Happy travels wherever you may go. And I hope you get plenty of biryanis in your lifetime.
I hope so. I hope they don't stop coming.
They will. I don't think they will. You can always return back to India for that. On that note, until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. Back to the biryani.
Back to the biryani.
Believe me when I say this, these are perhaps the best mussels that I've tasted in this part.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
I'm not going to say no.
It's called the kalamakaya.
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 The fruit that comes from the stone. Kallu is stone, kaya is fruit. So the fruit that comes from the stone. So the mussels come from the shell. And the shell is the stone. And therefore the kallu makaya.
Ah. Whoa.
What do you think?
If my hand wasn't dirty, I will give you a hug right now. Thank you. Thank you for suggesting. We can applaud it.
Absolutely.
Hope you enjoyed this Gourmet on the Road episode. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!